Womanlink Tech is about getting people together, getting all the networks, creating a huge ecosystem, because it's not one network, it's not one person that's going to make a difference. Obviously, we can all make a difference. But if you want really things to change, then we all have to all get together, we have to unite forces, do a real big movement, and then get things going in education, doing events, in entrepreneurship, with the startups. We have members in over 60 countries today. And I think if we all have the same energy and the same dream, we can make a change together.
I think I would like to see more women get into technology by maybe working more hand in hand with males. It's great to attend events where we see more males with women, you know, and try and find a solution to move positively forward.
71% of young women look to parents for advice, but 70% of teachers revealed that parents had put pressure on those young girls to stop taking those subjects and carrying it through to further and higher education. You are that age. Why do you think it is that people aren't carrying through STEM?
The types of toys and the stereotypes we're enforcing, even before there's this conversation of what careers you want to follow, the boys are more used to this type of language and terminology, and they're more used to this space, and they're used to the creativity that's involved in building things and making things and the enjoyment that comes from it, whereas sometimes girls, we're not so comfortable with that, and so we shy away because we don't want to put ourselves at risk of something we don't know.
There is a disconnect because it's kind of like this flat language of, well, what is tech? You know, it isn't all about coding, it's not just developers, and you know, I've spoke at schools and said there's this much that's actually development when you get the I'm not interested in coding of actually there's all these great things around it. We're putting an education piece together around actually having it that don't look at tech in isolation, blend it with your passion, because actually if you're interested in fashion, there's tech within fashion. If you're interested in banking, there's tech within that. And I think that's the whole piece that's missing at the moment, in the sense that you kind of get steered down this way of it's not for me, as opposed to, well, look at the ways it could be and look at the opportunity it could give you and look at how interesting it can be.
I have a 9-year-old girl. A couple of years back, the government put that it was an obligation to have coding within the curriculum for primary schools. So it's great, she's been doing coding for a couple of years now, but she still comes home and says, Mom, I love to do what Daddy would do because he has an amazing job and your job is absolutely boring, because they don't actually explain to her the true opportunities that tech provides. It's more of like, okay, this is on the curriculum, so this is from A to Z, what we need to deliver on the curriculum to this class, and that's about it. So there is a massive lack of education.
A couple of things come to my mind of how we can ensure that we don't just lower the barrier for women to enter technology, but also to retain talent. For example, returnship to work and flexible working hours, creating an environment for moms who return into work so that they can, you know, balance work life.
I think the last 5 to 10 years there's been massive changes for a lot of women that actually are working in tech. I think that it's really essential that companies understand how to integrate diversity culture that begins with, you know, your head of recruitment, head of people, but how do you roll that out to other touch points and managers across the company?
The change I would like to see for having more women come into STEM roles and, you know, in technology roles would be allow women who are at the entry stage do some more job shadowing so that they experience what it's like to be in a technology company.
Do you see amongst friends with teenage children that pressure from parents to take different careers is prevalent?
I think there is a role modelling, you know, challenge there, and I think it applies for routes into technology. It's like, if you don't know anybody who works in technology, then your source of information is films that you get or media stereotypes, which may or may not be appealing on depending on what you think about it. But if you've got no access to how do you get started in technology, then it's quite hard to break in, and what are your routes into it?
A lot of people, but particularly women, don't like to ask the questions because they think they're being stupid. But actually, probably most of the people in the room with you want to ask that same question. So have the faith and the courage to ask the question. Code's been really proud to be one of the sponsors and supporters of the chapter launch of Women in Tech UK, along with Empiric. This is a fantastic initiative. Those of you that have turned up tonight, please continue to support the chapter, support Umi and her team, because only that way are we really going to be able to make a difference for women in tech.